Sports Tonight is back again. We're reaching you live from Channels TV Sports Center in Lagos, Nigeria. Always a delight to have you join us. I'm Austin Okunakpan, action packed World of Sports. What got you talking over the weekend? I'm sure has been overruled by the talk that Sepp Blatter and Michel Platini has been banned. No more football related activities for 8 years. Can you believe that? I want to quickly get into that conversation so there won't be too much talk. Let me quickly introduce the guys in the studio. But before they get us, before they get talking, just to let you know that you can be part of the show tonight. Our Twitter handle is channels_sports, and on Facebook, we're channels-sports. So all of the talks about Sepp Blatter and then the suspension and then the bans and all of the investigation going on in FIFA, the corruption scandal, nobody is resting. You can actually, you know, stop at our Twitter page and talk to us. Also, all our top stories can be viewed on our website. It's channelstv.com and on YouTube /channelsweb. You're on the go. You can download the Channels TV app and be part of all we're doing here tonight. Yes, you can. Just go to m.channelstv.com and download the Channels TV app for your iPad, iPhone, BlackBerry, iOS, your Windows phone, and even your Android phones. Yes, your Android phones can also do it as simple as ABC. Download the app, m.channelstv.com, and then you'll be part of all we're doing tonight. I couldn't wait to introduce the guys in the studio so they can get talking, because I'm sure you cannot wait to also be part of what we're doing tonight. Tunde Koike is with us tonight. Tunde, good to have you on the show.
Thank you very much, Austin. Always a pleasure. Thank you.
And I'm glad you're not gloating about your place. Tonight on the show. And of course, Tobi Adekwaji also joins us. Tobi, good to have you on the show.
Good to be here, Austin.
We were talking yesterday about beach soccer and how we need to develop it in Nigeria. Yeah. But I'm sure that's not what got you talking. Actually, over the weekend, till this morning, what got you talking?
Well, plenty. Odun Adekore's remarkable run in the Indian Wrestling League got me talking as well. The axe that fell on Sepp Blatter and Michel Platini is also particularly important. That's shaking up a lot of things in global football as well. Also, the results in the various leagues all across the world. Mm. You know, it's been a really, really fun weekend for sport, actually.
That's right. Listening to what you say, you can totally agree that it's an action-packed world of sport. Before we get talking about Oduanyo Adekore, that's the lady on your screen, doing big things all the way from Accra on those stage, she got to India and she's beating everyone. It's been flawless for Oduanyo Adekore. 4 straight victories already. She maintains her unbeaten run, and today she did it in style. Another technical knockout against her Ukrainian opponent, Milia Orishma. And then today you came here, you spoke so well about this lady. You like what she's doing, and then it seems she keeps getting better.
I like what she's doing. I like what the Indians are doing. Mm-hmm. The Indians have a league for wrestling. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's the first of its kind anywhere in the world.
That's right.
And it's also a very lucrative league. So yeah, I mean, she's doing very not only well for herself, but I said doing well for Africans as well. She's flying. She's the only African, male or female, in the Indian Wrestling Professional League. The only African. That says a lot about the quality that she brings to the competition as well. 4 straight victories, 4 excellent victories. Mm. She's a firm fans' favorite wherever, sure, whenever she steps on the mat in whatever city that her team Garuda are competing in. And you know, she's obviously the standard. She and the team captain of Mumbai Garuda, that's multiple world champion Adeline Gray, 21-year-old American wrestler. They are the standard performers for their team. Flawless victories, both of them. 4 straight wins. And, you know, unsurprisingly, Mumbai Garuda are on top of the 6-team Indian Premier League. So, but Adekore's performance itself has been phenomenal. Mm. Her technical prowess, that's her right, ability, mm, on the mats has left a lot of people outstanding. She defeated one of the opponents in less than 2 minutes, and most of her wins have come by technical superiority.
Straight up.
You know what that is in other parlance, that would be a flawless victory.
That's right.
I mean, it's brilliant what the young woman is doing, and it can only serve to prepare her towards what will be a particularly difficult Olympic Games. Mm. Yes, she got a bronze medal at the Commonwealth Games, but make no mistake about it, the Olympic Games are probably three notches higher than the Commonwealth Games. And this is the best way for her to prepare. A lot of people are in the off-season, but she's still keeping fit. And I'm looking forward to great things, not only from her, but from the Nigerian Wrestling Federation as well.
That's right. The Nigerian Wrestling Federation are learning one or two things from these. I spoke to the president, Danny Gali, and he says you make sure he's there on the final day. Mm. Pick one or two things. You know, ask as motivation to Oduanyo Adekure. Right here, we just want to wish Oduanyo all the best. She's doing big things with wrestling. And let's just bring you this news bit. The International Association of Athletics Federation, they have confirmed May the 7th, 2016 for the fourth edition of the Okpekpe Road Race. That's it right there, Tobian. Fourth edition already loading. This is a competition that if we stay focused on it, can turn out to be something really, 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 really massive.
Yeah, really. I think the biggest thing for them is they have been consistent in terms of, you know, hosting the tournament and championship. And then just like you said, you know, we can make it bigger, you know, make it better. And also for Nigerian athletes, we've seen, you know, foreign athletes, you know, coming to the Okpekpe Race to come and, you know, conquer Nigerian athletes, you know, especially the Kenyans, you know. I mean, they have been really, really dominant in this championship. But, you know, I mean, you know, our athletes also can also step up, you know. This is something that could prepare them for challenges in the future. And I think we need to take this tournament very, very seriously. It's something that would help us, especially going to the Olympics next year.
I agree. I totally agree. Okay, leaving the road race now to table tennis. Let's go to France, where Nigeria's Aaron Okwadri, he plays for Jura Moraes. Also, Egypt's Omar Asab plays in the French Table Tennis League. Those guys, their rivalry cannot stop. On Thursday, Aaron Okwadri actually defeated Omar Asar to take his club, Jura Moraes, to seventh on the log. Yesterday, he did it in style again, leading his team to a 4-2 victory over another French club, Boulogne-Billancourt. 4-2. That's the breakdown of the result there. Aaron Okwadri winning the first game. Wang Zhen won the second game 3-2, lost the third one. The guy that Aaron Okwadri defeated went on the defeat one thing, and then Okwadri got back on the table to get it all done for his team. Now they are fifth on the table. We keep talking about Aaron Okwadri. That's it right there, confirmation for you. But Tunde Koike is important. He ended the year 2015 as world number 50. He says it's bad, but that the fact that he's playing league tennis, he can get better.
Absolutely. And the fact that he's playing competitive,
that's the word,
league tennis is also very, very instructive. And that is what the culture we're trying to build here in Nigeria. We talk about how, you know, a lot of these players are not well prepared to face their foreign counterparts, whether in West Africa or Africa or abroad. But the truth is, we cannot continue to rely on the Asojo Oba tournament or the Lagos table tennis classics for competition. We have to create a viable local circuit. And the truth is, it's table tennis. You don't really need much. You don't need the multi-billion dollar facilities to do anything. And trust me,
the
people will come and watch.
That's right.
Because by virtue of the way it's played, table tennis is an all-action sport. There is never a dull moment, and people want to see good table tennis. Even at the street corners, just watch two teenagers who can really play, watch them go at it. You'll see the crowd that will gather. Not to talk about professional table tennis players who are really good at it. So it's imperative that we start emulating best practices in the world. I still believe that it is possible to create a viable local circuit, table tennis circuit in Nigeria. Six regions, six cities: Lagos, Aba, Port Harcourt, Kano, and we can get it on. We can get it on the road.
I
but
agree.
Like we've said so many times on this program, it is time for a lot of these associations to start looking at, you know, constructive and really creative ways of alternative funding, and not waiting for, you know, the handouts from the government, and there has to be something that they can do. But congratulations to Aaron Okwadri. He's really keeping in fighting form.
That's right.
Hoping that next year will be much better. Maybe he can reclaim his excellent form of 2014, where he won two international awards.
Won two international awards, ended as world number 30.
Yeah.
No African had gotten to that level at that time. So big ups to Aaron Okwadri, because again, for us, we don't know what sort of preparations he's going to be having for the Olympics. Remember, he has qualified for the Olympics. So this serves as good preparations for him. He's playing in a competitive league, and he's dependable, he's reliable, and his team looks up to him to play and win. And that, for him, it's competitive enough towards the 2016 Olympics.
Yeah, really. Yeah, I mean, you know, if you're going to the Olympics, you need to be ready because you're playing with the Ajax, you know. I mean, you know, are the best players all over the world. And, you know, just like Tunde said, you can just rely on the classic alone or, you know, all these, you know, tournaments up to standard, you know. You need to play at the Ajax level. And this is what Aaron Okoro is doing. I mean, you know, playing this competition will really put him in very good shape, you know, in a very good mentality going to the Olympics. You know, Tunde have said a lot of things. You know, we need to develop on our sport. And, I mean, table tennis is one sport that can bring a lot of success to Nigeria.
Absolutely.
It's one sport that is very cheap, you know, to invest and also, you know, get success back. You know, with little millions, you can set up a very standard table tennis event. Tunde has suggested a zone or something. We can do state to state, and we might just have a very big, you know, table tennis championship in Nigeria, which can prepare, you know, our players, you know, going to, you know, tournaments in the future.
I totally agree with you guys. So that's the update. We've told you about the Okpekwe Road Race. We've told you about Oduanyi Adekunle right there in India. She's still doing big things. And of course, Aaron Okwadri representing big time for his club, Jura Morez in France. Let's go on a break now. We'll come back. The 2015 Copa Lagos has come and gone. It's Cote d'Ivoire again. They got here to retain their title. What are we not doing right? We'll talk about it. We'll come back. Stay. No one.